Hello everyone and welcome to this options talk 30 between Raghunath and me. Hope you are having a good long weekend and coming straight to charts today. Of course, I'll be speaking about charts and Raghunath will carry forward his calendar spreads now this time on weekly options. So we'll see what he has to say after I finish my charts. So coming to Nifty, it is very close to let me take the Nifty spot chart. Now this is in fact the last options talk of this year 2020. What a year has it been. Exactly 1 year back on 27 December Nifty was 12,200. If that time someone had said that Nifty will be close to 14,000 at the end of year 2020, people would have laughed slightly at him. If someone would have said Nifty will go first to 7,500 and then to 14,000, people would have just ignored him. But that is what has happened and that is what markets are. From 12,000 to 40 on 27 December, Nifty went all the way to 7,500 and now all the way back towards 14,000, 13,750. So what does the chart say now? It is very close to a double top. That last week's dip was heavily bought into and it was quite volatile. In fact, one day was a major fall which has not been seen for quite a long time. So it was enough to get bears active, but that enthusiasm was short-lived and straight away from Tuesday for the next 3 days, Nifty went up by almost 600 points because the low was near 13,150 and we closed near 13,750. So if this closes above 13,770 now, spot, closing above 770, then it will be another follow-through double top buy. And maybe we might see the count which was, in fact, there was an earlier count of 14,200 or 220, something like that. Maybe that can come fast, but of course, it has to remain above the, well, which is 770, 780. The last high was something like 777, 778. So crossing it and sustaining above it, that is more important. Because if it doesn't sustain, it can become volatile because it is at a very critical stage. This is the previous level on Nifty futures, so we'll have to be very alert. It's not that it just crossed, now it is a breakout, so it can, because in fact last Monday same thing had happened. Nifty spot made a new all-time high and from there went down 600 points. Why I'm cautioning is the Bank Nifty is still not out of the woods. You'll see here, this is an hourly candlestick chart. Bank Nifty has had a gap last Monday, after which it crashed. So it is still not even inside the gap. So this gap is what might act as a resistance. So this low, which was near 30,675 on futures, that is crucial. If it crosses and sustains above 30,700, then it's fine. But apart from that, there is another thing which is interesting on the Bank Nifty chart. Let me see where that chart is. Yeah, Bank Nifty futures. So if you look at the retracement, from the high to the recent low, that has crossed 78%. But if it goes below that again, let me mark it again. Yeah. Is near 30,400. So it is very close now. So if it sustains above 30,400 and then above 30,700, you can also safely expect Nifty to break out. In fact, Nifty might have already broken out. And then the path to 14,200 becomes clear. But at the same time, you need to watch these levels sustaining above 30,700 and 13,780 are extremely important. You cannot be sort of blind and say that okay, now it is going up. Another reason is this Nifty Bank Nifty ratio on a daily basis. This has given a breakdown. So this is another thing. This is a Nifty Bank to Nifty 50 ratio, which earlier I had been showing over here when it was giving a breakout, and after that we have come a really a long way. Bank Nifty has seriously outperformed, but now it is showing some first signs of weakness. So you need to be cautious on Bank Nifty, like I said, unless it crosses 30,750, 700. This is Bank Nifty on intraday basis. So this is also something which is not yet weak, but it is definitely showing some signs of at least a pause or a retracement. So everything points to that. The last question, which again is visible on the Bank Nifty put chart, I had talked about the 30,500 put above 650, and it had gone all the way to 1400, 1500 in just one day. So this is something which, although it has broken the low, it is, if it goes back above 500, then again the bulls might be in trouble. So these are the levels to watch out for on the Bank Nifty 30,500 put. And now if Nifty is likely to go back, go above 14,000 and go towards 14,200, there is another chart which I had shown earlier, which was the 13,700 call. Of course, this earlier count is not valid anymore, because the low has been broken. This was a huge fall on the single day on Monday, but after that it is now back near 150, and the previous high was near 210. So that might act as a resistance, because we saw some bearish column there and a huge bearish column on Monday. So right now it has crossed the bearish column high, but at the same time, this 13,700 call might face resistance near 200-220. If Nifty remains bullish, what can we look at in terms of stocks? One stock which has shown promise on Friday onwards was Reliance. This is the 2000 call, which is the almost at the money. Reliance is slightly lesser than 2000, the price of the stock. So this has shown some bullish trend on Friday. There is a good column here. So as long as that low is held, that this low is about 19. And if it crosses, this only worry is this is the bearish anchor column from 46, 47 to 18. So above 47 to this 65. So like 50 to 65 is a resistance. Right now it is, the price right now is near 30. So even on dip, if it doesn't break 15 and then it crosses this resistance, which is near 32, it can go towards 50 to 65. Of course, above 65, it will be a clean breakout, and maybe that might be very bullish for Reliance and naturally for Nifty as well. But watch out for 50 to 65 range on this 2000 call. In case Reliance, in case Nifty does not sustain above 30,200, then what? Then in that case, this old Maruti put, which I had talked about last time, which gave a good trade all the way from here to, it went to 330 or something like that. This is, in fact, Maruti is not yet strong. This put has, which is 7500, has not yet gone anywhere near the previous low. And right now it is 123. So the previous low was near 72. So any time if Nifty is not sustaining and if Maruti is showing weakness, this put might give a good trade again. So basically, if Nifty remains bullish, Reliance call. If Nifty does not remain bullish and shows bearishness, Maruti put. And of course, at the same time, watch that 30,500 put. So there are three potential trades possible, depending on which way the market goes in the next 3-4 days. But it is going to be, I feel it is going to be volatile, because it's the last four trading days of the year 2020, and you have seen how this whole year of 2020 has been. So fasten your seatbelts for the last 4 days of this year. That's all from my side, Raghunath. If no questions, then I'll pass it on to you.
I just had one question, that in general, right now the automobile sector is weak, right?
Yes.
If you check the ratio chart, I think even...
Yeah, absolutely.
So ideally, if the market breakdowns, then the automobile sector would be one, long put strategy.
Correct. And that is what is shown by this Maruti put also. It has gone nowhere near the lows. And Maruti also is not very strong right now. So, of course, Tata Motors is also there, Hero Motors is also there, Mahindra, a lot of stocks. But it's just that since I had spoken about this Maruti put, which it seems a lot of people traded, because I got a lot of messages, that's why I'm showing it again. How the same put can give a trade again, that is another, it's sort of an example.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Make me present.
Yeah, it's yours now.
Okay, thank you. You can see the screen?
Yeah.
Okay. So last week I talked about tire encounter, the one adjustment technique, and there are many adjustment techniques, and I will show you them, the other adjustment methods in the iron condor in the next options talk. But last week when I did this on the monthlies, iron condor adjustment on monthlies, a lot of people in the comment section asked the same to be done on the simulations on the weeklies. Though, I mean, I'm not a very keen person to do this kind of trades in weeklies, because the premiums that you get on weeklies are, you know, very less, and your ability to adjust is not as good as that you get in monthlies. So as a principle, I mean, because of these reasons that I've pointed out, I usually don't do weeklies, but because there's a demand for that, so I decided to do a simulations on the iron condor adjustments using weekly options. So there's a slight changes, obviously, because these are weeklies. The entry rules is different from that of monthly. Sorry, here it should be monthly options. So for weekly options, the entry should be 10 days to expiry of front weekly option. So on Monday, we have to enter the trade a week before expiry of the weekly. So if you are in 31 December is the current weekly, let's assume, then we would have entered this trade the previous Monday, which was on 21st December. So there should be a gap of 10 days. The reason for 10 days is that, I mean, ideally we could have gone to the Friday before that, but there is no liquidity in these weekly options before 10 days. So there was no chance of entering this kind of trade before 10 days. So it has to be on Monday, a week before. So again, you sell a put and call spread. So if you are new to this video, this particular iron condor adjustment, so I suggest you go back to Option Talk 29 to understand, you know, what I talked about iron condor adjustment in more depth. Okay, please go through that video. So these are the entry rules, and exit rules are again the same. Target is 50% of initial max profit, and stop loss should be 50% of initial max profit. If none of the above hits, we will exit this on Wednesday. Okay, Wednesday before the expiry date to avoid gamma risk. So our expiry date is on Thursday, so we have to exit no matter what on Wednesday, a day before the expiry, if either target or stop loss is not hit. All right. So these are the adjustment method for weeklies. So we adjust when the positional delta breaches 15 delta. So it could be minus 15 delta or plus 15 delta. Now we adjust by rolling up or rolling down the untested spread to collect more credit and increase the profit zone with the same minus 20 delta short strike, or the 20 delta short strike and 300 point width. And one change for the weeklies is that in the last week of expiry, okay, like, you know, after we move from the, you know, previous week to current week, there the width of the wing should be 200 points instead of 300 points, because we want to reduce the risk of gamma in the last week of expiry. So in order to reduce that risk, we reduce the point of the width to 200 points. And then again, we neutralize any remaining delta by buying a long option. It could be long put option or long call option. And we exit the long position when positional delta becomes below 5 delta after removing the long option. If the underlying breached the break even or the short strike, move the tested side tested spread further out of the money with the same minus 20 delta short strike and exit the long position. So repeat the steps above until stop loss or time stop loss is hit or the target is hit. So let's look at some simulations. So I thought of directly going and testing this with the recent one, the 24 December expiry one, where we had this huge swing of almost 600 points. So I chose 24 December expiry, okay? And then we have to go for 10 days before. So 10 days before will be 14th December, and again this will be on Monday. Okay, sorry, this should be 24. And the start date should be Monday. Okay, and our checkpoint time is 3:20. Alright, and so here we are using 24 December expiry. This is a weekly expiry. And we short 20 delta. Here this is 20 delta, but it's a 50 strike. So we choose 200 strike here. And then 300 point width. 200 minus 3. 12,900. And in the same way here also it's this 13,900 short and 300 points long. All right. So here the credit you are going to receive is around 4,100. So your maximum stop loss will be 2,000 almost. Yeah, happy. Are you asking
me? Yeah, in between your voice had gone when you selected the strikes. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. In between when you were selecting the strike price, your voice had gone. So if you can just quickly run through it once.
Okay. So we are choosing 20 delta here. So the closest one is 20 delta is this one. I personally don't like this 50 strikes because of liquidity issues. So I chose the nearest one. So 13,200 short, and then long is 300 point width. So this will be 12,900. So we buy this one. Okay, it's there. And similarly, we do the same with the call option as well. We short 13,900 call and buy 14,200 call, 300 point width. All right, so we receive 4,100 credit. So our stop loss should be 50% of this max profit. So it will be 2,000. Whenever we see 2,000, we exit. So now we proceed by one day. Okay, so nothing has happened. So you can keep checking our Greeks. So here it's breached. Let's check what happened previous day. So previous day it was at minus 14 and we went further. So then we saw this minus 20 delta, positional delta. So at this point of time we have to adjust because it has breached our delta. So we cover our put spread here for 9.2. So we are using the current price to exit 5. Alright, so now we choose 20 delta on the put side. So here is 20 delta sell 500 minus 3 here. Okay, bye. Let me check if it's are we in the which week. So we are still in the previous week, so we can maintain the 300 point width. 13,200. Okay, and then whatever the remaining delta is there, we neutralize with long option. So around 9 delta, we buy a long option. Maybe, yeah, this one is good enough. Okay, so our is close to zero, and let's look our chart, and we are still getting 5100 credit, so it's more than what we are getting earlier. All right, so we proceed further. Okay, breaks are fine. Okay, now it's minus 30. Let's go and look what happened. So this is on 21st December when, you know, the Nifty has dropped by around 600 points. So at this point of time, at our checkpoint, we have this loss. So at this point of time, our stop loss is hit. But what actually happened is that during the intraday, I mean before our checkpoint, actually if I, you know, go by 30 minutes and see what has happened in the morning itself, we have hit our target profit. So if you look, if I'm going by 30 minutes and you look at the profit, okay, around 1 o'clock itself our profit has hit by 2300. So if you didn't check, I mean, market before the our checkpoint time, which is around 3:20 in the evening, in the afternoon, and if you are a trader, you know, and you are in the market during the intraday period, then you would have got your target hit, which is 50% of max profit. Our max profit was around 4,100 initially. So 2,000 was the target. So we have already hit our target in this case. So I just wanted to make that point. So if you were in the market, you would have hit the point. And if you have checked only at the checkpoint time, then you would have booked your stop loss, which was around 5,300. So I just want to make that point. Okay, this is one simulation. And another simulation is, what we do is that we'll randomly...
And if someone would have not
checked in the intraday...
At all, that day, he would have been in handsome profit now.
yeah, exactly. So I'm showing it both ways that, you know, if you are a trader who are, you know, already in the market, you keep checking the market, then you would have hit already your target. But if you are a person like, you know, like we are going with the rules and we check only at 3:20 p.m., then you would have had to book your stop loss. That's the only point I was trying to make. So what I want to do this time is that I want to choose randomly one weekly option instead of, you know, predetermined weekly option, so that, you know, I don't have any price information and I don't know what Nifty was doing at that point of time, so that we follow the rules and see what happens, right? Whether if we follow the system, if we follow the process, you know, either we hit our stop loss or if we hit our target or we hit our time stop loss, something or the other will happen, and see how the process will work in our favor or not. So what we can do, we can choose maybe 10 September. So we choose 10 September. And so in this case, it will be on Monday. So 31 August will be our start date. Okay. So now we go to our checkpoint time, 31st August, 3:20 p.m. Okay, we enter 20 delta here. Now as you can see, before that, you will not have a very good liquidity. So that is the reason we had to choose Monday as our starting time point. Okay, 1100 minus 3, 10,800, 300 point width. And here 11,800. Okay, I don't have any price information, so just will follow the process. Okay. Okay, there is some issue. 300 point. Okay, here we didn't choose 300 point. Should be 10,700. Alright. Okay, so 4,600 is our credit or the max profit. So 2,300 will be stop loss or our target. So we proceed further. Okay, Greeks are fine. I think it should be fine. So we already hit our target. So I just randomly chose and we didn't have to do any adjustments. And we already hit our target. So nothing to do, just take it and be happy. I mean, how many days it took? We started on 31st of August. And in 4 days already we already hit our target. So I mean, it's as simple as that. Just follow the process and maybe we can do one more simulation, one more random simulation, maybe 23rd July, just to see if we get an adjustment. Okay, again 10 days before Monday. Okay, so we go to 3:20 p.m. checkpoint time. Again, follow our process. Okay, 300 point width. See, if you keep doing this, you will, you practice this and it will become so mechanical that, you know, you don't even have to look at Greeks at some point of time. It will become that easy. Because you get a feeling of, you know, what you're doing. Okay, again 4,900, so around 2,500 stop loss and target. So we go forward. Okay, here now we get an adjustment here. Actually, we didn't get an adjustment because we didn't breach our 15 delta. Okay, now we have breached. But you know, we can just take as a borderline in this case. I mean, 0.02 is nothing. Okay. Alright. So now here we have breached our Greek, right? So we make an adjustment here and we are actually in the next week. So on Monday. Okay, let's go and check. So we have to cover our put spread in this case. Right, 10.45. And then we put another put spread, same with 20 delta. So remember, I told that in this case, there is one modification. Once you enter the current week, we reduce our width to only 200 points. So in this case, 10,600, because we want to reduce our risk. Okay, so it will be unequal wing, little bit, but that's fine. And for the Greeks, so we have to buy 20 delta long option. So that will be maybe we can buy this 11,200. Okay. So let's check 2.3. Okay, fine. So now we proceed further. Okay, we already breached. So at this point of time, I mean, you can decide whether you want to go further or not, because we're already on to Tuesday, and we have to exit anyways on Wednesday. So at this point of time, you can just decide to, exit. There is no point to adjust at this point of time, and you are anyways you didn't get any loss, right? So I think that's enough in this case, that our adjustment has saved us from any loss. That is the takeaway from this, following this process, this simple process, only simple adjustments, and you follow them, you will not incur a major loss, and if everything works in our favor, it will hit our target. That is all from my side, AP.
Yeah, I think it's quite self-explanatory. No questions
Yeah.
needed, I think.
Yeah. Okay then.
It's just that you have to be a bit more active to do weekly, isn't it? Monthly, you can be a bit relaxed.
Yes. Yes. I mean, depends on market. If market doesn't move a lot, that's fine. If it
Yeah,
moves,
naturally, of
then
course.
you might need. Yeah.
But people still love weekly. That is the point.
Yeah, I mean, maybe, I mean, in that sense, weekly might actually work, because in the monthly, if you start, your credit will be anywhere around 6,500. So if you are lucky, maybe 7,000. But in weekly,
Correct.
it's always you are starting at 4,000. So you have,
Yeah.
4 weeks every month. So I mean,
So
it
even
might
if
work
you are
in.
lucky with 3 weeks out of 4, you will get a good profit.
Yeah, exactly. You just
Yeah.
follow this thing. I mean, follow the process, and I mean, in some weeks you may not gain anything, but you may not lose also anything. And if you're lucky, then you
Correct.
hit your target, and that's fine. So it is up to
Yeah.
people to check all the simulations and see if they continuously do in a month, what will happen. Or in multiple months. So you can do
Yeah.
your own test and see what happens. Just follow the process, that's all.
Correct.
Okay. Thank you
Okay,
guys.
fine then. Thank you.
Goodbye.
Yeah, goodbye.